In this video, I'm going to share some of the most important points while writing an academic paper. As you know, academic papers come in many forms, like school essays or term papers or assignments or project reports or dissertations or theses, monographs, and so on. The precise difference between all these terms remain vague most of the time. So the tips that I'm going to share in this video will help you no matter you are a school student writing a graded essay or a postdoctoral fellow writing a review paper. I have put a lot of effort to create this video to help all the students, so please watch it till the end. So let's begin. Tip number one is that make sure that your report contains no text effects or background colors or page borders and so on. Academic reports are serious and formal, so please don't use such effects and fancy stuff in your reports. Here is an example of a very poorly crafted academic paper. As you can see, the whole paper has lots of fancy effects, background colors. This color is a background color, as you can see that. And even the page border, all of these are really bad attributes of the research papers or the academic papers. And even the title, you can see that the title is in all capitals. You should completely avoid using all caps anywhere in academic papers except in abbreviations like DNA. As you can see, even the main body of this report is just fragmented sentences, not really formatted as a paragraph. It's not even forming a paragraph, it's just pieces of the sentences. So this kind of representation should be completely avoided. And this is an obviously downloaded picture, no source, no title, and no figure number, no figure legend. This is absolutely wrong way and there is no references as well. So this is one of a good example of a very bad academic paper. Tip number two, the body of your essay has to be divided into cohesive paragraphs. Broken sentences or lists are not allowed. Here is another example of a very poorly crafted academic report. You can see that introduction, all these are in full caps. This is not recommended. So full caps should be completely avoided. As you can see, the word has got default spell as well as a grammar check. So the student even hasn't incorporated suggested changes. For example, here is a full stop. After full stop, there should be one space. So that space hasn't been incorporated into this essay. So if you scroll down, you can see there are a lot of problems with this paper. For example, CO2 is not properly formatted. CO2 is not, this is not the right way to write it. Or if you look at here, 1, 2, 3, this is not a proper list, you know. Or if you look again still further, you can see that all these are just broken sentences, you know, pieces of sentences, doesn't form any paragraph. It's just like our first term paper. So this is really a bad way to write a term paper. It's a very good example that shows how not to write your term papers.
Tip number three, paragraphs have to be properly formatted with first line indentation.
You can also see that this term paper has no paragraph formatting. For example, here you can see that this is justified, but the first line has no indentation. To do this paragraph formatting, you can just click Ctrl A or select everything, then go to the home tab and then paragraph. And here you will have to choose the special first line and click OK. So this is the way to form the paragraph formatting. Now it is properly formatted. What the side headings should not be part of the paragraph. So this is how to format your side heading. Again, the side headings here is in all caps, which is wrong. It has to be the normal way, you know, and there are a lot of issues with this paper. For example, one example could be here, right here. Anywhere I point, you can see one or two mistakes. Here you can see that the comma should be here and then the space, not here. The space, then comma, and without space, 2.5. All these are really wrong. Here is another example, atmosphere, comma, else. Why? After comma, there should be a space. So CO2 in the seawater, look at here. C has to be capital, O has to be capital. Again, this CO2 is also a wrong way to write it. Or full stop, and before full stop, there is a space. Why a space? After full stop, there should be a space here. This is also not there. PH, this is not the way to write the PH. So all these are the problems.
Tip number four, the whole paper has to be divided into a title page. That is your first page containing your title and the student's name or the author name. Second page should contain your abstract with the keywords. Third page onwards, the main content will start. So that will start with an introduction and end with conclusion. For primary research papers, IMRAD is a common format. That is introduction, then materials and methods, then results and discussion. Finally, all these papers should contain properly formatted reference section in the end. Tip number 5. Lists and bullets have to be properly formatted with appropriate functions inside the Microsoft Word. But my advice is that please avoid using lists and bullets completely, you know, and use only sparingly.
If you scroll down, you can see a very poorly crafted list as well. So this is not a proper list. This, as you can see, if it's a proper list, the moment I click here one, all the rest should be highlighted. So this is not a list. To properly format this as a list, so you need to use the list function of this word. So here it is the list function. So either bulleted or the number. So if you want to use, the student has to use the number. So let us choose the numbered list. So the moment you click numbered list, now it is properly formatted with the indentation, you see. So if I click this number one, all the rest is also being selected. So this is a properly formatted list. So earlier it was not. You can see that earlier the problem is that this is not a list. While to create this list, you will have to choose the list function.
Number 6, pages has to be properly paginated. That means each page should contain the page number except the title page. The page number should appear at the bottom center of each page.
You can also see that the student did not use the pagination function of the word to paginate the document. To paginate the document, you will have to go first to the Insert tab, then Header and Footer. So the submenu will have page number. So you will have to click the drop down menu and click here bottom of the page and number 2, that is plain number in the center of the bottom of the page. So this is now properly formatted, as you can see that. So you just have to click close the header or footer, or just click anywhere. So you can now see that number 4, then the next page is number 5. So this is the way to insert the page number or to paginate the document. In addition to the pagination, some journals also insist you to put the line numbers. To put the line numbers, you have to click layout tab and then the line numbers. So any of these options you can choose. You can simply choose continuous options. So that means that from the beginning, all these, the lines will be sequentially numbered. So it is now numbered line. So usually the academic reports, if you're submitting to the university, will not insist you for the line numbers.
Number 7, same font has to be used throughout your paper. I suggest Times New Roman font because it's used quite often in academic script. It's formally looking, plus it saves a lot of printer cartridge as well as paper. Font size of 12 is commonly recommended, along with 1.5 line space justified. 8. All figures and tables should be cited in the text. 9. All figures and tables should have proper number and should contain the captions. I suggest to redraw simple illustrations with a free software like Inkscape or even with a pen and paper rather than simply copying from elsewhere. Please invest some efforts to draft a quality report. 11. Ensure no redundancy. Same data that is presented in figure should not be presented again in table and the other way around. Also, data that is presented in figures or tables should not be again elaborated in the text. 12. References has to be properly formatted with hanging indentation. Bulleted or numbered references are not good traits of an academic paper. 13. Use a standard referencing style for your papers. For example, APA 7th edition is commonly recommended for sciences and MLA style is commonly recommended for arts. 14. All cited in-text references should be appearing in the reference section at the end. 15. All the references that appear in the reference section in the end should be cited in-text as well. 16. Non-scholarly websites like Wikipedia or Google or personal websites or blogs should not be cited in an academic paper. 17. All binomial names or scientific names should be in italics. 18. In binomial names, genus names should be in full when used for the first time but abbreviated henceforth except in the beginning of the sentence where no abbreviations are allowed. 19. Chemical formulas should be properly formatted with subscript as well as superscripts. 20. Proper symbols should be used in units of measurements.
So here is an example of a very good report. So as you can see, the first page has only the title and the authors. the only that information. The second page has got abstract, and as you can see, this is properly formatted. So second page has only abstract and the keywords, while the third page onwards is introduction, then continues till the conclusion. So this one is a research paper, and as you can see that it has got materials and methods, then results and discussion, right? You can also see that the whole manuscript is in the same font and same size, and you know, everything is exactly same. So the uniformity is very important in any academic manuscript. The line spacing is also same throughout the manuscript. All figures and tables are properly numbered, sequentially numbered, and each a figure as well as table has got the figure captions. So the right way to put the caption for the figure is underneath. As you can see, this is figure 8 and the caption, while for the table it is on the top of the table. You can see that this is table number 1, and on the top of the table is a caption, you know, the table number plus the caption. You can also see that these tables are cited in the text. You can see that two-way ANOVA in bracket table 1, right? So this one is table 1. So this is called inside citation. Here is another example. Michelis Menten equation of uptake kinetics in bracket figure 8. So here is a figure 8. So the figure 8 has been cited in the text. So this is called in-text citations. You can also see that illustrations have been original, right? This illustration, I made it using Inkscape. So you can also attempt to make this similar kind of beautiful vector-based illustrations using Inkscape, which is completely free of charge. You can download it, right? So in case if I downloaded this one from many open source resources, like copyright-free resources, then I can properly source it. You know, the reference is downloaded from the credit has to be properly sourced underneath the figure. So if I go to the reference section, you will see that the reference section is also properly formatted with hanging indentations. You know, you can see that this one, this kind of indentation is known as hanging indentation. Let us go back to the earlier report. Here you can see that these references are not properly formatted. So how to apply the hanging indentation for the reference section? That is what I would like to show you. So here it is not properly hanging indentation. More than that, this is all wrong. You know, this this kind of website alone should never be cited as a reference. So anyway, just to show you how to put this hanging indentation, just select this reference and then just click the home tab and then click the paragraph. Here the special here, instead of just first line, that is what we did it for paragraph. Here we'll have to choose hanging and then just accept whatever the default delimiter and click OK. Now you can see that the reference list has properly formatted with the hanging indentation, though it is totally incorrect way of making it. For example, this reference has got no year and no title, no page numbers. This is totally incomplete reference, and this effort by the student is really poor. Also note that each and every citations of this will appear inside the text. So this is known as in-text citation. For example, Nishihara et al. 2005 will also appear, or Ray et al. 1999. So you can see that both of these, for example, Nishihara appears here. You can see that Nishihara and Ray will also appear somewhere here. So this is that Ray's reference. So each and every one of these references should appear in text, and in-text reference should also appear in the reference section. So this is very important hallmark of an academic paper. Also note that the reference section do not contain Google or Wikipedia or blogs or random websites or ResearchGate, those kind of websites. Also note that the binomial names are properly formatted with proper italics, or the units have proper symbols, the scientific notations have been given in the units. As well as you can see that the chemical symbols like NH4 are properly formatted. All these are very important when you're writing an academic paper.
21. Grammar and spelling mistakes should be properly checked with the built-in add-ins of Microsoft Word or any other word processor that you are using, as well as with Grammarly. 22. Plagiarism should be checked with appropriate plagiarism detecting software like Urkund or Authenticate or Turnitin, and the plagiarism report should be attached with your report. 23. Language used in academic report has to be formal and technical. Avoid slangs and informal everyday expressions. 24. Ensure to write in a polite language. 25. Ensure that the report is up to date and all the key references published in the last 3 years are included in your report. You can make use of date delimiter option in Google Scholar for this. You can download all these points as a checklist. The link is given in the description section of this video. By the way, I'm a big fan of the checklist. I call it as silver bullets of the productivity. I have checklists of all sorts, for example, travel packing list or lab meeting or even for creating YouTube videos like this. Now, let me share some good and bad practices of academic writing. Number one, the first principle of a good academic writing is exam's razor concept. Look for simple solutions rather than unnecessarily complicated solutions. You can't mask mediocrity with sophistry. Number two, be resourceful. Read a lot first before start writing. No one can write tabula rasa, that is the blank slate. Three, read articles fully before citing them in your paper, not just abstract. You have to download the paper, the full text paper, and read it completely. If you have no access to a full text paper, you can contact the authors or you can ask the teachers for their help. Please don't cite articles you haven't read just because you guessed the contents from the title or just because some other paper have cited that paper. Friends, this problem is quite universal. You know, we share the posts in the Facebook and WhatsApp without even reading the contents. I have featured this omnipresent problem in one of my earlier videos. Please have a look. 4. Start with skeleton or structure or outline of the paper. As you read more and more papers, you know, you add these points into that skeleton and expand these ideas. 5. A good essay should form a storyline with logical flow and interconnectedness. Connection of these ideas such that it sticks together is called cohesiveness. Cohesiveness should be at the sentence level, paragraph level, and the whole paper level. Each paragraph should be focused on one point, and paragraphs should be connected with each other, not just merely scattered pieces of information. 6. Perhaps it's a good idea to start this skeleton or the structure of the manuscript in your own mother tongue, you know, and expand it to include, you know, more and more points as you read more. The reason is that most of us think in our mother tongue, and the logical cohesiveness comes natural to us when we write it in our mother tongue. While converting the skeleton into the first draft, then you can switch to English. 7. Excellent essays make use of something called dialectics, the art of making cogent, compelling, and persuasive arguments. So, read more about dialectics and incorporate effective tactics of it into your essay. 8. Ensure that your academic paper has all the three hallmarks of style and eloquence. First is purity. Purity is all about good English. Second is perspicuity. That is about the clarity in expression. That is to avoid unequivocal and unambiguous statements. Third is precision. That is to avoid tautology and redundancies. 9. Double check for tautology that substantially degrades your essay. An example of tautology is given below. Lineage sorting is the sorting of lineages. When the lineage sort in one way or another, this is called lineage sorting. The whole sentence conveys nothing other than senseless wordplay. 10. Brevity is very important in academic writings. Please don't fill your academic manuscript with nonsense words and fillers and redundant information just to increase the word count in the hopes of getting a better grade. Teachers, do read your academic papers very carefully. So my advice is to make your academic papers as succinct, clear, original, and to the point rather than boring piece that has stretched out like an elastic. 11. Articulate a masterly prose in a well-crafted diction. For this, you can read a lot of great prose. For example, the prose written by Darcy Thompson or Stephen Jay Gould. 12. Use elegant variation with the help of a good thesaurus. I use a dictionary called Word Web Pro with Chambers Thesaurus add-in in my PC. But mind that don't abuse such elegant variation and synonyms. Don't use such synonyms without properly understanding the meanings, especially meanings in context. Also, don't use these complicated synonyms just to make your essay appear more sophisticated. Mind that it's a clear sign of mediocrity in writing. 13. Always source reliable references to support consequential statement and substantial claims and numbers. Reliable references are published works of scholarly literature and academic books. Websites or blogs or Wikipedia or non-academic books are not reliable sources of information. 14. Avoid passive voice as much as possible because it leads to ambiguity. 15. Check your manuscript thoroughly for usage consistency, including hyphenation, spelling variations, abbreviations in multiple forms, and so on. One easy way is to paste your manuscript into the Google Docs and open the document, add in a consistency checker. 16. Don't waste your time formatting references and citations manually. Instead, invest your time learning some good reference manager softwares like EndNote or Mendeley. 17. Write abstract or summary after completing the main body of the text. A summary of this video is provided along with the checklist in the bottom description section of this video. Please make good use of it. Hope this video has been useful to you. I also hope you will appreciate my efforts on creating useful videos like this. Please subscribe to my channel by clicking the red subscribe icon right here in the corner. By the way, have you seen Curiosity, the weekly science program of my channel yet? Please watch Curiosity. Link is given in the description section of this video as well. My best wishes to all of you. See you.